grassroots level, but I don't think our CM has done anything of this sort. He has not been to the grassroots level and he doesn't know how we are suffering today. All of us are suffering, we don't know what to do, whether we will be okay carrying on our business or no. So because of this, we said that we'll meet today in an emergency meeting, but we couldn't meet today because of social distancing and the curfew. Many of our members called us up and told us that, see, you better talk about us, and we have to start a business immediately. We can't carry on paying salaries and paying all other expenses which are incurred by the hotel industry. We have made a few points where we said that we would approach the CM and tell him that we cannot carry on our business without these things. We have made a request to him that he has to roll back this gazette which he has published yesterday and be normal and with the same rate what we had paid last year. We can't carry on with this, the new rates and the new gazette, whatever he has put in. We have asked him also that he has to give us a discount or rebate in the sense of at least cut the 2 months which we have suffered in terms of excess fees and all other implications. We have asked him also to renew our license for the next 5 years at the same rate and deducting the lockdown period of 2 months, whatever. We are not sure whether it's going to be 2 months or more. It depends, because up till now we are not assured that we'll be opening on the 17th. But the assurance given to us is that we might open on the 17th, but depending on the number of cases that Goa might have. Today we are in the green zone, but tomorrow if we turn into orange or red, then I don't think 17th would be a date that we could open up. We also want to request the CM that we have a lot of stock in terms of beer which is going to expire, and some have already expired. So we want the CM to at least give us an opportunity to dispose our stock, sell it off or parcel it off, which is not permitted as per our license. But because of this stock, we are going to suffer some more losses. So we want the CM to give us some permission at least so that we can dispose all the stock out from it. We have also decided to ask the CM that he should help us out by government of India is already giving us some financial assistance, because it was announced by the Prime Minister yesterday that about 200 lakh crores would be distributed all over Goa. So that could at least offset his budget provisions, whatever he has made, so that we could get some relief in all this.
If you see the general sentiment, in fact, as a lawyer for Goa Bar and Restaurant Owners Association since morning and since yesterday evening, since the gazette became viral, we have been getting calls, and I've been getting calls saying that, you know, this is absolutely cruel, and not at a time when this pandemic has already taken over the better sense of the business. If you see the restaurant owners are already suffering since March because of absolute closure. They have been burdened with full payment of full salaries. They have been burdened with payment of rents, the other amounts which they have to deal with, the fixed costs. And today, if you see the increase in excise license fees, it is going to be absolutely overburdening on all of them. And if you see, it's not just about restaurant doesn't mean the high-end restaurant. It also means the smallest tavern and the bar, which is there, and the middle income group and the low income group. They all are part of the hospitality industry, which runs restaurants. They are one of the backbones of tourism industry, and that is why I can understand the sentiments when they say that this is cruel and this is going to destroy us completely with the hikes which are proposed and which doesn't seem to have some kind of sensible thinking behind it.
So what is the demand now?
The demand is to roll back absolutely the hike in excise license fees. In fact, in the earlier memorandum which was drafted on behalf of the association, a request was made to reduce the fees and not charge or absolute renewal of licenses till next year, 2020 to 2021. And that has been considered by many other states. And if you see the 2 months that the restaurants have lost on prorata basis to reduce those license fees, because the restaurants are not in operations, the licenses have expired and you've not been able to renew them also. Like the way the CRZ licenses have been made for 3 years or 5 years, make it renewable for 4 to 5 years, because every time it is required to be renewed, it's a very cumbersome process.
What did you say about this, that wine shops have been allowed to be open, though with social distancing, but bar and restaurants? are still closed.
That arbitrariness is felt by the restaurant owners also. They feel arbitrary in view of the fact that even the licenses now, which are the license fees which has been sought to be imposed, is on the basis of the carpet area of the shops now or the restaurants. Now there are so many, like if you consider for example a pharmacy, if you have a 10 square meter pharmacy or a 50 square meter pharmacy, the license fees do not depend on the number or the area of the premises. It depends on the particular shop. So why this differentiation is what is being felt by the restaurant owners also, and in a time when then there is no business absolutely, and when they are not allowed to operate with particular guidelines also.
So how long you all can wait till though you all have requested CM to roll back? So if it doesn't happen or something, because even though the business is not working.
Yeah, if it doesn't roll back, we'll have to take some certain steps which we have not decided as yet. We feel that if better sense prevails, he'll roll back the whole thing.
He has been very cooperative earlier times, and I'm sure in this particular situation also this would be considered. But it is the timing with the gazette notification has been published. It is on 12th May, and it's something that was decided in the budget. But obviously, probably it might have not been considered that it should go for publication or not. But I'm sure he should be able to consider this aspect of this hike in fees and roll back the fees as far as the industry is concerned.